Super Typhoon Pepito leaves over 3,000 individuals stranded in ports. The Philippine Coast Guard says those persons are currently in 45 ports in Calabarzon, Eastern Visayas, and Bicol region. Sea travel has been called off in the said areas due to the threat of the storm. Hundreds of vessels are also taking shelter in ports. The Philippine Health Department raises code white alert in preparation for the potential impact of Super Typhoon Pepito. Under this, health personnel and staff in public hospitals are on standby to provide prompt medical assistance to those affected by the typhoon. Regions such as Metro Manila, Bicol, and Eastern Visayas have also declared a code white alert as part of their emergency response measures. The DOH urging the public, especially vulnerable groups and residents in high-risk areas, to prepare emergency kits and evacuate early to ensure their safety. And the Philippines on high alert as Pepito strengthens into a super typhoon. The storm was last spotted east of Kataraman, northern Samar, with maximum sustained winds of 185 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 230 kilometers per hour. Signal number 4 has been raised over Catanduanes in the northeastern portion of Camarines Sur, while other parts of Luzon and Visayas are under varying wind signals. Pagasa Weather Bureau has warned signal number 5 may be issued if conditions worsen. The super typhoon is forecast to make landfall over Catanduanes tonight or early tomorrow morning, November 17. But it could shift direction, potentially making landfall along the eastern coasts of Camarines Sur, Albay, Quezon, or Aurora by tomorrow afternoon or evening. Pepito is expected to weaken as it moves toward the West Philippine Sea and exit the Philippine area of responsibility by Monday. The Philippine government in full preparation mode as Super Typhoon Pepito approaches. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has directed all agencies to prioritize moving residents to higher ground amid warnings of deadly storm surges that could reach up to 3 meters. Nearly 2 million people in coastal areas across Calabarzon, the Bicol region, and Eastern Visayas are at risk due to the typhoon.
It's not enough to move them away from the sea. We have to get them to high ground. We have to give very specific guidance to the LGUs as to how to deal with the storm surge. Again, I know that the critical element when it comes to storm surge is not the distance from the high water, from the high tide mark, but it is the elevation above the high water mark. That is the key element. If it's a 3 meter storm surge, we have to get people at least 5 meters above that level.
Marcos also confirmed relief packs and search and rescue assets have been pre-positioned in areas likely to be hardest hit.
Ang una natin ginagawa ay we have to redistribute our assets na ginagamit natin para sa mga nakaraang bagyo na mostly Dukan and Northern Luzon. So we have to reposition many of our assets to make sure that at least in the search and rescue phase that we are ready or we have our assets available.
Philippine authorities suspending travel in areas lying in the path of potentially destructive Typhoon Pepito. The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board suspend all land travel by buses and trucks bound for Visayas and Mindanao via Matnog Port in Sorsogon and other areas in Bicol. The Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange also announced the cancellation of the following trips. Several flights are also canceled today due to the bad weather. Take a look. Albay is gearing up for the expected onslaught of Super Typhoon Pepito as it nears the Bicol region. Our correspondent Jervis Manahan is on the line to report on the situation there. Jervis, good afternoon.
Yes, Rica, winds are getting stronger here in Legazpi, Albay, and earlier today we have experienced light rains, but generally it's still very cloudy here. Waves got strong very early this morning because of the high tide, but as you can see, waves and the sea is a little calm now. Residents are prepared for the onslaught of Typhoon Pepito. They have fixed their homes, placed sandbags in their gates, while some cover their glass windows with plywood. Even the fishermen secure their boats to safe places. Legazpi Mayor Alfredo Garbin said they are aiming for zero casualty this time. More than 137,000 individuals have preemptively evacuated in around 70 evacuation centers here in Legazpi City. Most shops and establishments are closed today, but the LGU assured that vital institutions such as hospitals and even pharmacies are working and open and accessible to the public. They also ensure that there are pharmacies open in case people would need to buy medicines. Rescue boats are in place and food packs have been prepositioned to respond to the needs of residents in the light of Super Typhoon Pepito. Rica.
Thank you so much, Jervis Manahan, reporting live. Meanwhile, the curfew is now in effect in Naga City and Camarines Sur in anticipation of Super Typhoon Pepito's wrath. The local government says locals are required to stay in their homes or in evacuation centers for safety. Private establishments also told to suspend operations while the curfew is in effect. Operations of vehicles, except those used for essential services and for emergency response, are also prohibited. The province of Apayao bracing for the expected onslaught of Super Typhoon Pepito. The local disaster management office says displaced residents have temporarily returned to their homes to repair the damage caused by Storm Ophel. Strong winds have battered the province, causing roofs to be torn off and power outages in several areas. But the local government says it is prepared to evacuate residents again if necessary as Pepito approaches.
Ready naman po sila and ready po ang mga nakapreposition din po na food pack. Sa ngayon po, close po muna ang evacuation center pero mag-open po ulit pag meron na naman po tayong may raise na signal and lalo-lalo na po sa mga nasa front area. Kasi balikan po muna sila para ayusin po ang kanilang mga bahay-bahayan.
The provincial government of Northern Samar assures the public it is prepared for the impact of Typhoon Pepito. Disaster officials there say they already ordered a preemptive evacuation in the affected municipalities. As of now, there are already around 20,000 evacuees in the area.
We always consider naman yung social distancing pa rin kahit wala ng COVID for health reasons, no? It's always integrated in our policy sa mga evacuation centers. Ang buong probinsya at national government ay nag-preposition naman ng sapat na pagkain for this evacuees, no? Mga around 50,000 food packs. So wala rin pong problema dito. May mga modular tents kami, no? Wala pa nung COVID-19 pandemics. Hanggang ngayon, practice na yan ng mga evacuation centers natin.
Telco firms also bracing for Pepito's impact. Globe Telecom in a statement said teams and equipment are on standby in southern and central Luzon as well as in eastern Visayas. The telco company also assured customers its network facilities have generator sets in the event of power outages. PLDT also giving the assurance it's augmenting its pre-positioned teams and resources in the aftermath of Typhoon Ophel and with the expected impact of Pepito. Meteorologists worldwide know the unusual stream of storms that have ravaged the Philippines in the last 4 weeks. A local meteorologist warns pre-developing La Nina conditions play a role in the inclement weather.
In just 4 weeks, 6 cyclones have battered the Philippines. The string of storms began with severe tropical storm Christine, which entered the Philippine area of responsibility on October 20. Christine drenched the Bicol region with torrential rains and forced the evacuation of thousands of residents in Isabela province when it made landfall on October 23. Over 3.3 million Filipinos were affected by Christine's effects. Barely a day after Christine's onslaught, Leon entered the PAR and quickly intensified as a super typhoon. Philippine disaster officials estimate around 150 people were killed in the onslaught of the back-to-back storms. Two more storms entered the PAR in the first week of November. Typhoon Marce rapidly intensified before making landfall near Santa Ana, Cagayan on November 7. It exited PAR a day after, but not before wreaking havoc in northern Luzon. Typhoon Nika followed days after, prompting the evacuation of some 32,000 Filipinos living in vulnerable areas. And just a week after back-to-back typhoons, the looming Typhoon Pepito threatens to wreak havoc over Luzon just hours after Typhoon Ophel lashed at the provinces of Cagayan and Isabela.
Tayo ay nasa tinatawag na pre-developing La Nina. So hindi pa La Nina. Natapos yung El Nino nung Mayo, pero sa ngayon, nasa neutral phase tayo, hindi El Nino at hindi rin La Nina. Pero dahil pre-developing yung La Nina, ibig sabihin po ay lumalamig yung tubig ng Dagat Pasipiko sa gitnang bahagi at sa silangang bahagi. Pero yung mainit na tubig ng Pacific Ocean, nasa silangan natin. So parang may incubator sa tabi ng Pilipinas, pero sa dagat. So pangunahing sangkapo para mabuo ang bagyo ay ang mainit na karagatan. Bakit puro Northern Luzon? Kapag ganitong buwan, Nobyembre, ang nadadala ng bagyo, Bicol, Visayas, Mindanao, patawid po ng West Philippine Sea. So kapag buwan po ng Nobyembre, Disyembre, January, ay merong malakas na high pressure area dyan sa may Japan. Tinutulak na yung bagyo, hinaharangan na yung bagyo para hindi makaakyat sa Northern Luzon. Ngayon po ay wala po yung harang na yon, kaya po nakakarating pa sa Northern Luzon. So itong frequency na to, no, na sunod-sunod na magkakasunod nga na anim na bagyo, Northern Luzon, similar areas yung tinatamaan, ito po ay unusual or hindi normal na pangyayari.
A United Nations assessment of the past month's weather disasters found the string of storms have damaged over 207,000 homes and displaced nearly 700,000 people. NASA's Deep Space Climate Satellite also spotted the four most recent cyclones near the Philippines. The satellite image shows tropical cyclones Marce, Nika, Ophel, and Pepito lining up in the western Pacific. NASA notes the oddity of the four storms churned together. According to the Japan Meteorological Agency, this is the first time so many storms coexisted in the Pacific Basin in November since records began in 1951. Meanwhile, the UP Resilience Institute and NOAA Center, which has mapped out flood-prone areas in the country, advises four provinces to be on alert for heavy flooding due to Pepito. They also urge the public to check their website, noaa.up.edu.ph, to see which areas will be severely flooded and which places they can evacuate.
According to the forecast, these places, Albay, Catanduanes, Sorsogon, and Northern Samar, are the ones expected to have intense to torrential rainfall. But of course, the distribution of the rainfall will be uneven and the floods will happen not everywhere but in places where the water can flow with least resistance.
The chief Philippine weatherman fends off accusations by a town mayor that his bureau failed to give advanced warning of Typhoon Ophel's landfall. Pagasa Administrator Nathaniel Servando reminds local officials that a typhoon's track can change any time. Servando also tells them to be guided by wind signals instead of just focusing on where a storm will make landfall. The Alcala mayor in Cagayan Province had bashed Pag-asa online for supposedly not warning that her town was in the direct path of Typhoon Ophel. But Servando points out that wind signal number 4 was already raised over northeastern Cagayan, which includes the town of Alcala.
Kahit na sa isang particular na bayan lang na tumama ang sentro, but of course the same effects ang maramdaman nito ng mga karatig bayan. Sana po ay palagi nating tandaan, wag lamang tayo magbantay no kung kailan maglandfall ang sentro nito. But of course, tingnan natin yung pangkalahatan ang sirkulasyon ng bagyo.
The November 17 show of the Grand Biniverse concert has been rescheduled to a later date due to the anticipated bad weather from Super Typhoon Pepito. In a statement, Star Music said the Sunday show will be moved to Tuesday, November 19, to ensure everyone's safety. Those who will be unable to attend the show on the new day can also ask for a refund. Passes for the live stream of the concert on the affected date will also be valid for the rescheduled show on Tuesday. Meanwhile, the Grand Biniverse concert on Saturday and Monday will proceed as planned. Part of the proceeds from the Grand Biniverse concert will be donated to the ABS Foundation to help storm victims.